Finally, we have it. Searchable drop-down list in Excel.
Yeah!
Even our cameraman's excited. It's the feature we've been waiting for. Before, to get this to work, you had to write complex formulas. Now it's just there by default. And yes, it's there for the desktop version of Excel as well, currently in the beta channel, but hopefully soon in the general channel for Office 365. Let me just show you. So imagine you're finally planning your first team gathering after many months of having online meetings. Finally, you're going to meet in person and you want to bring your team great appetizers and desserts. You want them to fill out this list and you want to create drop-down lists for them to select from. You've created a list of your favorite appetizers and desserts. Hopefully, your team members will find something they like here. And you want to create drop-down lists here. You're going to go to Data, Data Validation. For Allow, instead of any value, we're going to go with List. Source is going to be our lists here. And I'm going to select this. So notice I'm selecting empty cells on the bottom here, right? So if you're familiar with Data Validation List, there is nothing new here except when your team member comes to select their appetizer. They're going to click this and it's going to be a bit confusing. They want something with cheese. So as they type in cheese, they're going to see anything that includes the word cheese. So this drop-down list has become searchable. So I would go with bread and cheese. Now I'm going to copy this. Let's just bring the data validation list to these cells as well. So let's right mouse click, paste special, and just paste the validation and OK. So now check this out. When I click on this drop-down, I don't see those extra empty cells that I selected. This behavior is new as well, so empty cells are automatically suppressed, which means that I don't have to convert my original list into a table or use named ranges. I can just add extra cells to this. And whenever I come up with new items, I just add them to the bottom. Now, when we switch back to sheet one here, I put chips there. So let's see, soup and chips is there as well. What about dessert? So my original dessert list is right here, but apparently someone didn't like my ideas because they went ahead and they deleted some of them. Well, it doesn't matter. I want to select this list, but is my drop-down list going to automatically exclude those empty cells that are in between here? Well, let's test it out. I'm going to highlight this range. Let's say I want drop-down list for all of these cells and go to data validation, switch this to a list, and for source, we're going to select this right here. Click on OK. Now let's check. So I'm going to go with one of my favorite foods, peanut butter. Everything that has the word peanut butter pops up here. So it doesn't matter if it's at the beginning or at the end of the word, you're going to see it in this list. Now you can move with the arrow keys. And once you select something, I actually like all of these, but I'm going to go with Nutella and peanut butter and press enter. And you have that value in the cell. So here we have peanut butter cheesecake, press enter. And it's right there. So two great improvements. One, we have autocomplete or searchable drop-down lists. And two, blank cells are automatically excluded. Now, another great feature that we got is this little thing that popped up here. So every time you right mouse click on a cell, you're going to see this search box. You have the ability to search for things that might not be here. They might also be here. So let's say you can't be bothered to go all the way down with your mouse and select something. You can type it in here. Or if you're looking for something that's not on this list, it's not a problem. Let's say I want to clear all the contents of this cell. I'm going to start typing clear, and I see clear right here. So I'm going to go down with my arrow key. Then let's use the right arrow key to bring up the menu. And if I go to clear all, I'm going to clear everything from the cell. So formatting, data validation, everything got cleared. Let's try this with something else. Let's go and search for table. Let's say I want to convert this into an Excel table. I have insert table, format as table. When I use the right arrow key, I can select my type of formatting, just press enter, and I get, do I want to create the table? This looks right. Just press enter again, and this is an official Excel table. Okay, so we now have that search box when we right mouse click on a cell. It doesn't appear if I right mouse click inside a table, but if I'm not in a table, it appears. Okay, so these are two great additions coming to Excel. Now, I'm wondering, if you were attending my little team gathering, what would you pick for your appetizer and your dessert? Will you find something here? So for me personally, I'm probably going to go with this one as my appetizer. And this one as my dessert. What about you? Let me know in the comments.
So I know a few people who switched to Google Sheets just because of this feature. Google Sheets had it, Excel didn't. Now Excel has it, at least it's gonna have it in the Office 365 version. By the way, the web version already had it some time ago. It was just missing in desktop. Okay, so that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this update. If you did, hit that thumbs up, subscribe to be updated on Office products, and I'm gonna see you in the next video.